problem with 767, and we had this problem for at least 2 months now. I don't know, maybe between $50,000 up to $100,000. I don't know, but a lot. 3 days ago, we burned 4 tons of fuel only because of this problem. So 4 tons of fuel is about $3,000 or more. Okay, so the story is, 767 have two engines, and the other engine was always going up. It's like there are two modes. It's a flight idle, and then you have approach idle. When you have approach idle, the engine goes up in power. This is because of if something happens, they can respond quickly. And this engine was going to a high idle on ground, intermittent. We managed to keep the aircraft flying like that legally. It was okay. This problem has been ongoing for, I would say, seven, eight weeks. And we've been replacing that and this and that and blah, 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 blah. I found the problem yesterday with my colleague. The guy that I was working with, he's more electrical than I am. Together, we managed to figure this problem. It's too soon to celebrate because it could come again. But the aircraft flew from here to Paris and back without the problem. And I managed to find the problem with the MacBook. The thing is, it was in the end, the aircraft is like left hand side of the electrical shelf is identical to the left hand left and right should be doing the same, right? We run the engine. I could see with the mark probe that one of the relays was not energized as the left one should be, and that gives us a clue that hey, this relay is. And we changed the relay, and same thing. So we took the relay from the left-hand side and put it to the right, and we had the same thing. So, but anyway, the relay was not doing this job. This relay was the relay to control this high idle and low idle. So we took the relay out, and we found out that it was one pin, it was losing ground. So we managed to fix that, and we put the relay back in, and for two flights now, it's okay. And this is probably one of the trickiest problems I ever had. Yeah, but we were lucky last 5 days, it started to be a hard fault. That's why we burned about 3-4 tons of fuel. But in my case yesterday, it's like the relays in those aircrafts are like three, like this. Mm-hmm. So this is working, this is not working, and then you have this not working. So it's like, so basically this tool saved because a lot of money, because in 7 days the aircraft would be grounded.
Wow.
For good, because we had three times extensions.
Wow. Which means that could have cost them millions.